life that's not tattooed on. Amen. You've got to be able to say, holy, 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 holy. Look, you're able to say, well, oh, we're going to force people to choose saying that. Experience the supernatural, then God wants to be you to be available for his super ability day by day. Woo! God, that's heavy and that's deep. He wants us to be saved daily. Daily I shall worship the Lamb of God. Y'all ain't talking daily. Isn't there anybody understand that you got to be saved 24/7, 7 days a week, 365 days of the year? Somebody holler daily. Hallelujah. The main purpose of the baptism in the Holy Ghost in this life then is to give us more power, watch this, to demonstrate Christ and win people to him. So the Holy Ghost comes to adorn you with weaponry, not only to protect you from the elements of the dark world that comes against us, but also to give us ability, amen, to demonstrate God-like or Christ-like power here on earth to win folk to God. Meaning you're going to be different. You don't have a whole lot of friends if you say it for real. They don't get tired of you talking about Jesus. But when you really get the Holy Ghost, amen, it's just like, I'm really in love with my wife, so it ain't a day that go by, come on, that she don't run across my mind. Hallelujah. And that's how Jesus want to be. It's some, no, you shouldn't be able to be in no conversation or any conversation where you don't say Jesus somewhere. I ain't got no help. But this ain't no place for Jesus, and that's why they call, he ain't there no more. No, Jesus getting in bed with you. Even when you romantic, amen. Yeah, he right there because he ain't strange. You don't trip him out. It don't excite him. Say amen. You know what I'm talking about? Somebody say, Jesus don't care about your sex life. He cares about your whole life. Come on, somebody. Acts 1 and 8, all other things being equal, the believer baptized in the Spirit will have more success in preaching the gospel. In other words, and you would believe, you were a believer, but you got a lot of preachers who don't have the Holy Ghost. They got a ghost, but it ain't the Holy Ghost. I don't know if it's space ghost, Catholic friendly ghost, I don't know what ghost it is. It's their ghost. He said, and it came in as a wrestling mighty wind, watch it now, and say that it came like cloven tongues of fire, and it set upon each of them. And all of them began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave utterance. And that was some of the apostle. If the book means just what it says, it is the acts. Come on, somebody. Or it is the actions. Come on, somebody. It is the actions of the apostle. And so it was the action of the apostle based on the power that was on the inside. And so when it set upon them, what the text is saying, that they begin to speak in other other tongues as the Spirit gave utterance. As the Spirit. So once the Spirit came and settled him, and he began to speak in Swahili, and he began to speak in America, and he began, you began to speak in German, as the Spirit gave up, y'all they say everything. And the power in that was released, that they were speaking in a language fluently that they had never been taught. Look at somebody and say, power. I got a witness around here. And for those of you who said, I had the Holy Ghost for 15 years and I ain't spoken tongues. Tongues is a gift, you is a lie. That is not true. That is the evidence. Have I got some help here? Now, that don't mean you're going to speak in tongues every other word, but somewhere between the Holy Ghost and now, you should have spake one time. Touch me, people, and say, may the force, may the force. Problem with it is we're in church with nothing behind us, with nothing in us, with all the accoutrements on the outside, but no demonstration or evidence emanating from the inside. Oh, Lord, help me here. Have I got a witness in the house? Touch somebody and tell them it's going to be all right.